It's one of those moments you know is coming, but it doesn't make it any less significant. The Rainbow Warrior basketball team learned its dance hall and partner today for the NCAA tournament. Sports director Rob DiMello was in Anaheim for the big reveal and spoke with the team about what it all means.
How's it going, everybody? Aloha from Anaheim. We're after three magical days in March. The madness continues for the Big West Conference champion University of Hawaii men's basketball team Sunday as the NCAA tournament brackets were revealed this afternoon directly across the street from the Honda Center where the Bows won the BWC title. Now, they watched the program before family and friends where the Bows learned that they will be headed to Spokane, Washington as a 13 seed facing California in the opening round of the NCAA tournament. And after waiting 14 years to break out their dancing shoes, Bows are beyond beaming to be Pacific Northwest bound for the big dance.
It's just a great feeling. Like I said, I could talk about this till I'm blue in the face. I know how many people have put a lot into this program. I know how special a place Hawaii is. We know how special a place Hawaii is. And so we represent something a lot bigger than this program. But it starts there, and just very appreciative for a lot of people to have a special moment. I know a lot of people, there are a lot of smiles on people's faces. And at the same time, there's a lot of focus to continue to see if we can move forward.
I mean, it was great, you know. This is what every college basketball player dreams of. You know, and to experience this my senior year, I couldn't ask for anything better.
We're going to enjoy this. Not everybody gets to go to the NCAA tournament, especially from the Big West. So to be that only team to make it and to have a chance to play and against a good team, it's going to be a lot of fun. And, you know, we're up for it.
All right. California in the first round in Spokane, Washington. What's the first thing that comes to mind when you saw that?
We were supposed to play them earlier in the year, but, you know, they canceled that tournament. That was the first thing that came to mind. But everybody predict, you know, they'll win because they're a higher seed, but you know, it's upsets all the time. So, you know, we're the underdog, you know, we'll just come out and play, have fun, you know, and try to win.
Now again, Rainbow Warriors and Golden Bears set for Friday. The Bows will stay here in Anaheim over the next couple of days, holding practices until they fly out on Wednesday for Washington. I'll be along for the ride with the Bows every step of the way, so stay tuned to KHON2, both on air and online. Reporting from Orange County, I'm Rob DiMello, KHON2 Sports.
Thanks a lot, Rob. We'll hear more from Rob's interview with the men's head coach later in sports, along with Sam Spangler. He caught up with the champion Lady Bows, who returned to Hawaii today. Their tournament matchup will be announced tomorrow. The impact of both teams getting bids was not lost on former players and coaches. Alexander Zanes caught up with some of them and joins us now with that. Alexander?
Thanks a lot, Kathy. I spoke with two former Rainbow greats and a former Rainbow Wahine coach today about what this means to them and the state of Hawaii.
When the Rainbow Wahine returned trophy in hand today, it was shakas and smiles for Coach Beeman and the ladies.
I was sitting on the plane this morning and I had over 100 text messages, and I started to get to them, and some of the things that people were saying was just, Nani Cockett, for example, proud to be a Rainbow Wahine again, and that made me tear up on the plane. And I was sitting there going, oh my gosh, you know, for someone like Nani to say that, and Vince Gu to say, job well done. You know, those are the people that have laid the path, and those are the people that we wanted to make proud and continue to play for.
The two people Coach Beeman mentioned, former Rainbow Wahine star Nani Cockett and former coach Vince Gu, both told me today just how much this means to them and to the state of Hawaii.
I hope that the coaches, and I know they will, and the players, I hope they realize how much pride they brought back to a once proud Wahine basketball program. And there's been 18 teams before this year that did not accomplish what they did yesterday. So that's a great feeling.
It was so excited that the men and the women got a chance to redeem their championship runs. And when I was watching, I was just at the edge of my seat the whole time. And you know, once they got that big lead, I was like, okay, I can relax a little more. But I'm super excited for them.
Former Rainbow Warrior star Alika Smith said he's been following both teams, and he knows just how big it is for both of them to be going to the tournament.
I think it's huge. With the men's and women's going, it's something that hasn't been done since, I think, 94. And back then when they had Nani Cockett, and the boys' side had, you know, Tony Maroney, Jaron Akana, and all those guys. I just think it's great for the state. The whole state is behind them, and wishing them success and moving forward.
It's a privilege, you know, and it's a blessing to be a part of it. And, you know, for the whole state of Hawaii, I mean, the neat thing that we all know is that no program impacts their whole state like Hawaii does. We truly are Hawaii's team, and that's what's special about it. I mean, I know everyone at home was going nuts, and that's, you know, that's special. That is that intangible thing that is priceless.
Really exciting stuff. And Kathy, as you said, coming up in sports, Sam Spangler and Rob DeMello with more continuing coverage of the double rainbow trip to the NCAAs. Alexander Zanes, KHON 2 News.
Thanks so much, Alexander. And it didn't take long to get those words, Big West Champs, on a t-shirt, and not any longer to snatch them up. The H-Zone at Ward Villages is the official store for the Athletics Department, so it had those shirts in stock first thing this morning. It was busy all day with foot traffic and online orders from here and on the continent. H-Zone says 100% of proceeds from all its merchandise benefits student athletes and the Athletics Department.